Hey, welcome back. This is part two of like animation. In this tutorial, I will show you how to do like animation with style component in Code Sandbox. So let's get started.
Let's open new project. Click on new sandbox. Choose React by Code Sandbox. Alright, this is your project. The app.js, this is where we're going to put the SVG code here. And this is your browser. For this section, we are not going to use style.css. I'm going to use style component. So go to add dependency, search for style component. And now let's import style. I'm gonna use keyframe because we're going to use animation later. Keyframe style component. Next, let's declare a new constant wrapper. So I'm gonna use property for my wrapper. I'm going to go back to Figma to select background. Go to the right panel, click on inspect. We have code and CSS. So we're gonna need this line of code. So the array give property for you, position, width and height, and the background color. Command C for copy, and let's go back to code sandbox. So let's paste here. Then that we're going to replace div at wrapper. Now we're going to go back to Figma. This time select on the group line, click on your mouse, copy as SVG. It's amazing because you don't need to code, it's already provide code for you. All the property is inside SVG already. So go back to code sandbox. Let's paste here inside the wrapper. And then I'm going to add class after SVG. Last name is equal to lines. Then let's click on path. Path is where I'm going to animate my stroke path. We can select on the path together so we can name on the same time. Command D. Click. You see the right line? Go to the bottom. Press on right arrow key. Then press on space. Let's add ID is equal to line one. Escape. So now this one, I'm gonna change line one for line two. So at this part, I'm going to repeat. I'm going to go faster. Okay. Now it's done. And when I press save, it's gonna organize the line for me. So this part I can delete. Let's go to Figma. So this time I'm going to select ring one. Right click on the mouse, copy as SVG. Go back, make some space, paste here. So for this one, we're gonna do the same steps. Add class after SVG. This is for positioning the group. Class name is equal to ring one. Escape. So here we have three circles. So let's select command D to name it at the same time. Press on right arrow key space ID equal ring one. Save. This part I'm going to delete. Back to Figma. Let's select ring two. So this part I'm going to go faster because it's repeat steps. Okay. By the following step, add class after SVG and then select on the path and circles, add ID after it. All right, we are done. Let's go back to Figma. We're going to select stroke. Copy as SVG, go back to code sandbox. I'm going to paste after ring six. I'm going to do the same step. I can add class after SVG and then add ID after circles and path. Next, go back to Figma. Now we're going to select medium circle. Right click on your mouse, copy as SVG, go back to Scott sandbox. We're going to paste after stroke. This, we're going the same steps. We're going to add class after SVG. For this ellipse, we don't need to add ID because they don't have stroke for animate. Because for this one, I plan to do a thread in animation. I just need class. Let's go back and select small circles. Right click, search, copy as SVG. Go back to Go Sandbox, paste it here. Same thing for this one. I just need to create class. Class name is equal to circle. Because I'm just going to animate the circle thread in, so I don't need, because they don't have stroke, we don't need to add ID. Let's add style. Let's create lines property. This one, I'm going to go back to Figma, then select lines. Let's go to inspect, copy this property because they already give position for you. And go back to code sandbox, paste your property here. Width and height, which we already have in SVG, so we don't need to add here. All right, and I'm gonna ring class for ring one. Go back to Figma and select on ring one. Copy this code, go back, paste it here. We're just going to read width and height. Save. Let's create class ring two. Go back to Figma, select ring two and copy this line of code. Go back to the project and paste here. And SVG decide they can create the blur. That's why when I delete width and height, the position is changing. So I have to change manual left and top to fit my design. 60. You just play with it. It's center. I'm going to repeat the steps and I'm going to go faster on this part, okay? All right, now good position. See, we fit the line here. So now let's add class for stroke. Class stroke. So we're going back to Figma and click on stroke. Then go to expect. Let's copy CSS code. Go back to code sandbox and paste your property here. Let's delete width and height. So we're going to change the left position and top position. Let's add class M circles. Again, let's go back to Figma. Select on medium circles. Copy the CSS code. Go back in code sandbox. Paste here. So this again, I have to play position. Let's create class circle. Back to Figma, select small circles. Copy CSS code. Let's go back to project. Paste here. Now we are done with positioning. You can click on this icon. Now you see the design is done. So now we have to create animation. I want my background to center. I'm gonna add margin 0 auto. And when you click on a phone view, it's center. Now we are ready to create animation. Let's declare new constants. And then animation is gonna mean dash is equal to keyframe. The initial state from stroke dash set value 2000. End state to stroke dash offset. I set value for 0. Let's create another animation. This animation I'm gonna name fit in. It's equal to keyframe. The initial state from opacity 0. End state to opacity 1. I'm gonna set a property for my ID, line 1. Let's add stroke array. I set value for 100 for now. Now let's add stroke dash offset. I will set value for 1000. Animation is dash. I will set the duration for 3 seconds. No delay for this one. And then I use linear. I use linear and forward. I'm just going to copy ID here. I'm going to use comma and paste. I'm going to add 2. And then I'm going to add comma here. And change for 3. Okay. So I have 19, so this part I'm going to repeat. Same thing with stroke, I'm going to add ID stroke. Now for the rings, I'm going to use different. Now for a ring, I'm just going to copy this line of code. Okay, I'm going to paste here and I'm going to change for ring 1. Save. I'm gonna use delay 0.3 seconds. I'm gonna change the dash offset for 400. All right let's copy this line of code, change for ring 2. So I want to add delay for this one. Let's try delay 1 second. All right, it's connect. Let's repeat the same step. We're going to copy and paste on the rings. So I'm going to go faster. No worries, I'm gonna share my God sandbox file with you. So you're gonna have all the properties. All right, now I finished playing. Now let's add some animation for my circles. All right, let's add animation. Animation is fit in. I will set duration for 0.5 seconds. Gonna use 3 second delay. And this animation I'm gonna use easy in out. Forgot to add opacity to 0. All right, save and let's refresh again. All right, and then I'm just going to copy this line of code. We're gonna paste inside M circles. Like this, save, refresh. Same thing with this one. Don't forget to add opacity. Save. Okay. Now. All right, now we finish. Animation is done. Let's check the final result. Wow, isn't it amazing? Wow. So that's it for today's tutorial. If you guys like this tutorial, please don't forget to subscribe. And if you have some feedback for me, please let a comment below.
Bye.